Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am Canan Doğruöz, and today I will make a presentation titled A View to Concept of Work Safety in Construction Industry from the Perspective of Hoftili's Cultural Dimensions Theory, Example of Turkey. This is my outline of the presentation. Although the concept of work safety was introduced in very old days, it has gained more importance with recently increased turnover, particularly in the construction industry. As is known, the construction industry leads the way in industries where work accidents happen the most worldwide. The concept of work safety is therefore very important to any actor that plays a role in the construction industry. Interactions of all stakeholders with each other in the industry allow work to be complementary to each other and to form a whole, resulting in the dynamic structure of the industry. Besides, all the actors in the industry gather together to form small groups. The behaviors and attitudes of these groups are effective in the operation of processes. What keeps these small groups together in their cultural structure? The culture constitutes society's perspective of life and lifestyles, both as an individual and in groups. The relationships between the persons allow them to work together, form their perspective of concepts of success, tolerance and limits, determine the extent of their expectations from the future, and identify the type of bond they have established with the past. Therefore, the concept of culture is a multidisciplinary area and has junctions with many areas of work. The work accidents in the construction industry are critical for the structure of culture where such accidents happen. The perspective of countries with different cultural values for work excellence is also different. At this point, the cultural structure of groups of different sizes in the construction industry considerably affects the concept of work safety in the industry. The purpose of this study is to interpret the work accidents occurring in the construction industry in cultural terms in societies with different values for cultural dimensions. For this reason, the concept of work safety in the Turkish construction industry was interpreted from the perspective of Hoftili's cultural dimensions theory. The methods of this study involved a description of Hoftili's cultural dimensions. The dimensions involving different countries were sampled, and it was described how cultural differences could affect work safety in the construction industry. The limitation of this study is that the study provides an evaluation only across Turkey. Although the cultures have been investigated by the anthropologists for many centuries, they have been largely ignored in different areas of research until several decades before Hoftili. The increased interest in management, psychology, education, and intercultural matters has been triggered by the Hoftili's cultural dimensions theory. Hoftili was the first person who provided a derived cultural model. Hoftili's study constitutes a very advanced major international example for the time, research design, and data analysis techniques. The result of that study, also known as IBM Study Now, defined and sequenced countries in various cultural dimensions with a number of quantitative indicators. Hoftili's study is significant to provide a net model of the cultural differences, to allow culture to become operational and to facilitate inclusions of the culture in various models as a variable. For this reason, this study is based on the cultural dimensions defined by Hoftili. First, Hoftili's cultural dimensions were examined as a study method. Second, how countries are scored by dimensions was described. Then the scores of different countries from Hoftili's cultural dimensions were analyzed. The position of different countries in cultural dimensions was sampled, and work safety cultural relationship in societies was investigated on the example of Turkey. According to Hoftili, the culture is to collectively program the mind that distinguishes a group or group of people from the others. Hoftili's cultural dimensions theory was suggested to measure the impact of culture on interpersonal communications in the social structure. This theory was first introduced into the literature by the sociologist Gerhard Heinrich Hoftili and examines the impact of culture on the interactions between the persons that work together in different disciplines. Hoftili formed his studies between 1967 and 1973 through 116,000 questionnaires administered on IBM in 20 different languages and responders from 72 different nations. As a result of his study, Hoftili suggested four different cultural dimensions, including power distance, individualism versus collectivism, uncertainty avoidance, and femininity versus masculinity. Two cultural differences were added to these four cultural dimensions by studies in the following years. Subsequently, other dimensions include long-term orientation versus short-term orientation and indulgence versus restraint. Figure 1 shows the Hofstede's cultural dimensions. Power distance is the extent to which the less powerful members of institutions and organizations within a country accept that power is distributed unequally. In societies with high power distance, inequality of having power is supported by the followers as well as leaders. Power distance refers to the degree of inequality of the people who live in the same society. Individualism versus collectivism is about the predisposition of persons in a society to be integrated into groups. In individualist societies, the ties between the individuals are loose. Everyone is only tied to themselves and immediate family. In the collectivist societies, the persons are in the large families that look after them from the birth. Individuality and collectivism are the opposite concepts. Uncertainty avoidance is the extent to which the members of a society tolerate uncertainties. It indicates how members of the community feel uncomfortable in unstructured situations, or they are programmed to feel comfortable. The unstructured situations are new, unknown, and non-normal conditions. In societies that avoid uncertainties, the members strictly adhere to the rules and laws. The different options are rejected, and there is absolute truth. The concept of masculinity versus femininity appears in societies as a reflection of gender-specific attitudes and behaviors on the culture, not as an individual characteristic. National cultural differences between masculinity versus femininity dimensions affect the meaning of the life for working people. The societies with higher masculinity show competitive attitudes. The societies with higher femininity are humble and affectionate. After four cultural dimensions suggested by Hofstede in the 1970s, the dimension long-term orientation versus short-term orientation, which can be associated with the hard work, was suggested by Michael Harrisborn in the late 1980s. Since none of four dimensions defined by Hofstede is related to economic growth, the results of that study were also approved by Hofstede and incorporated in the theory as the fifth cultural dimension. The values of the long-term orientation are determination, economy, sorting relationships by condition, and sense of embarrassment. The values of the short-term orientation are mutual, social obligations, respect for traditions, personal stability, and stability. After the fifth dimension, Michael Minkow, a Bulgarian linguist and psychologist, contacted Hofstede in the early 2000s to investigate the cultural dimensions in more depth. The dimension indulgence versus restraint was included in the literature as the sixth dimension. The dimension indulgence versus restraint addresses the aspects related to happiness that is not covered by other five dimensions. Indulgence refers to a society that allows to relatively free human desires, either fundamental or neutral, related to enjoying life and having fun. The restraint represents a society that controls the satisfaction of needs and is regulated by strict social norms. Hofstede formed his studies between 1967 and 1973 through 116,000 questionnaires administered on IBM in 20 different languages and responders from 72 nations. According to the result of his questionnaire, the countries are scored ganging from 0 to 100 based on their cultural structure. Table 1 shows the description of all dimensions scored 0 to 100. Table 2 shows the score for the power distance, individualism versus collectivism, uncertainty avoidance, masculinity versus femininity in the analysis of cultural dimensions conducted in different countries. In the dimension power distance, Turkey is among the countries with high power distance with 66 points. The societies with high power distance are a hierarchical society where indirect communication is established and that is not open to new ideas. The employees in such societies trust in managers and will not question their decisions. The employees are notified of what to do by their superior or chief. In societies with high power distance, such as Turkey, work accidents may occur because occupational safety companies receive instructions or orders from the employer, the associated problems are communicated to the employer, and the final decision maker is also the employer. In the dimension individualism, collectivism, Turkey is among the countries close to collectivist countries with 37 points. The concept of we is important in the collectivist societies, and the persons are expected to faithfully abide by the groups they are included in. It's important to adapt to your own group and express conflicts are avoided. As a return of all these, interpersonal relationships may outweigh and require duties. The thought that nothing will happen to us in the collectivist societies such as Turkey makes interpersonal relationships more important than the responsibilities and causes to ignore the disturbances to prevent adaptation to own group, resulting in the increased number of work accidents. In the dimension certainty, uncertainty avoidance, Turkey's score is 85, which includes it in the countries that avoid uncertainties. The societies that avoid uncertainties are not open to innovations, avoid anxiety, and look at the future with suspicion. In societies that avoid uncertainties, such as Turkey, there is a tendency to establish beliefs and institutions to avoid uncertainties. There is a belief-based approach, desire of God, to work accidents that occur frequently in our country, which could be a good example of it. After work, accident happens, the resulting consequences are not attributed to measures not taken, but rather to a divine power independent of persons and government agencies. This is a common practice. In the dimension masculinity versus femininity, Turkey is the feminine area with 46 points. The societies in the feminine area avoid conflicts and care for consensus, and in such societies, soft aspects of person such as sympathy are more prominent. The competition and success orientation do not come to the forefront as in the masculine societies. From this perspective, the characteristics of a feminine society are also parallel to the characteristics of a collectivist society. The legal regulations entered into force and occupational health and safety in the whole world and Turkey are intended to prevent work accidents and reduce the loss of life and property of in the construction industry as in the any of the industries. However, enforcement of such legal regulation is directly related to the cultural structure of the society. All the actors involved in the construction industry form a specific culture in their own groups in the construction industry as in any industry. No doubt that the cultural impact of their community dominates over the formation of culture in such small communities with the society. It's important to understand such formed culture in order to determine the group dynamics and develop human-oriented, feasible, and sustainable politics. This is possible by regarding the groups working together not only as a structure that produces goods, provides services, but also adopting an approach accepting that a group refers to a culture where it interacts with its members. The concept of culture is a multidisciplinary concept that has a relationship with the area of occupational health and safety, as in many areas. The cultural structure of different groups of persons involved in the area of occupational health and safety determines the perspective of occupational health and safety. This study examined the Hoftidi's cultural dimensions theory, addressed the cultural characteristics of different countries, and interpreted the work safety culture relationship on the example of Turkey. The work safety in the construction industry requires actors from many different disciplines to work together. The cultural structure of societies also affects the way of working. The societies in different cultural areas address the concept of occupational health and safety in construction in different ways. The cultural structure ensures the stability of work safety in some societies, but causes interruptions in practices in some societies. According to Hoftidi's cultural dimensions theory, Turkey has a high power distance, collectivist, avoids uncertainties, and bears feminine characteristics. The hierarchical structure brought by power distance, involvement in a group as required by a collectivist society, uncertain conditions caused by the avoidance of uncertainties, attribution to beliefs, and prominent sense of sympathy brought by a feminine society appear to be parallel to each other. It's surely unavoidable that a society with a hierarchical structure is also a society that cares about the adaptation to groups and uncertain situations are accepted based on the belief system in societies that avoid uncertainties and do not accept different opinions. Since the cultural structure of societies will not undergo radical changes in short periods from today to tomorrow, the problems in the area of work safety may be remedied by different practices as in many areas. It's considered that work accidents may be reduced by regulations, practices, and even penal sanctions that suit the cultural structure of society. Thank you for your attention.